Hello there and welcome to my first episode of City Skylines. Today I want to show you how I've built this mountain railway, which is inspired by Central Europe style railways like in Switzerland or Austria, where I live. It handles a height difference of nearly 300 meters, which is pretty reasonably for a railway line. And I think we'll start with the time lapse. So I've already built this part of the track off screen, which is actually only this bridge. But I pretty much liked how it turned out, so I've decided to keep it and build my city around this. Then I started to search for a place where this railway actually goes, and I found a pretty nice kind of plateau up there at 360 meters height, where I plan to build a smaller town which will be connected to my big city down below. But there is still about 40 meters of height difference, so I've decided to go around this pit and build a bridge over the track there again, which actually looks pretty cool, to gain a bit of height. And then it was actually possible to connect up the railway to this plateau. It's actually not very easy to make a steady slope in this game, so I've decided to make plateaus about 100 meters long each, and each of these plateaus is followed by another one 2 meters higher than the one before. This creates a pretty nice steady slope for the railway. It's not perfect, but it's about as good as you can get in City Skylines, I think. And I think it's pretty much the most realistic railway I've seen yet in this game. So yeah, there's I've built this bridge over there again. As you can see, I've pretty much deleted most of the curves a few times to make it look quite nice. Yeah, after placing the tracks, I've used smooth tool a lot to make the plateaus as small as possible around the track. I pretty much like this tunnel portal because the ones the game creates are not the most realistic, because they tend to be very long and not really kind of tunnel portal style. I've also added a few rocks there, make it look more detailed. It turned out pretty nice in the end, but I'll also modify it a few more times. So I'm now placing the tunnel to go up to the spot where I plan to build the mountain town up there. As I've said, it's about at 360 meters above. I don't know what it's counted on sea level. Maybe not, but above ground level, I guess. Was not really sure which station to use, so I used this Russian one. I think it's Russian one in the end. It looks pretty cool. It's also not the easiest thing in this game to build kind of realistic junctions. I've done my best. So here I've decided to fill this whole pit with water and make a nice mountains lake and a small waterfall beside the railway there. I think it looks pretty cool in the end. If it wasn't the easiest thing to make this waterfall working. But yeah, eventually I'll manage it. So now I go on with the railway downwards with a pretty long tunnel through this mountain there. There I start measuring the length again. I'm placing down these trees to know where the segments end. And after adjusting the terrain, I go on with the track placement. It's actually a pretty time-consuming method of building a railroad, but unfortunately you can't really build the railway first and adjust the terrain to it. You have to make it the other way around. So I've decided to go down there a bit, then make nearly a full turn at this mountain there, and actually go back to a lake way in the back of the map. Later on I've recognized that this curve is actually too tight. It had a radius of about a bit over 100 meters or so, which is still too tight for railways. If you want to build main lines, but the tightest curve you can go is about 160 meters radius, which is still pretty wide actually, but railways don't really do very sharp turns. Right over there, I've gone over to give up this time-consuming length measurement method, and I've just made it as long as I thought it would fit. So as I've said, I'm adjusting the curve there, make it a bit wider. I also wasn't really sure from there on how I'm gonna manage to ever get down to my main town, which is at about 60 meters height. And I've decided to go way back there, make kind of a turning tunnel, and then go back again. which you'll see in a moment. So there's the entrance for the turning tunnel, and it's gonna come out about 20 meters below, going over there with a little bridge. Gonna use nice tunnel portals there again. There we go. So as you can see, we've already made about 30 or 40 meters height difference again, which is pretty cool. And you can also see how limited railways actually are in reality. Or also in the game, if you want to place them realistically. So here I was able to make a bit wider curves. It's gonna be a faster piece of track later on. I've also decided to add a station down there, because I think I'll also make a little village beside this lake there. Also added one up there. So as you can see, we're already down to about 150 meters. So about 100 meters left. So it's becoming manageable. So now we're going over this river again. It's actually kind of a canyon. So here was the last tricky part. I've decided to pretty much keep the terrain there and build the railway around and below it. So there are gonna be, I think there are three or four tunnels and one bridge, which were a nightmare to place down. But after a few adjustments, it looks very cool, I think. So there you can see me kind of building the first iteration of this. Actually, I'll delete nearly the whole thing again later on. But yeah, as I said, in the end it turned out pretty nice. Yeah, so there you can see me struggling with the tunnel system again. It's not the easiest thing to place down tunnel entrances with nice and smooth tracks going in. Yeah, so only a few meters left and there I'll go into the city. This is all gonna be part of the city later on, so yeah. That was it for a time-lapse. And now I can see a few shots of the train going up the track. So that was it for this episode. As you might know, you can like or dislike and comment this video, so feel free to do that, and I'll be happy to see you next time. Bye.